In this video, we're looking at a mass revolving on a smooth horizontal tabletop. It's attached to a string, and we're given the length of that. And this time, we're told the breaking strength of this string. So that's the maximum tension you can put on it before it breaks. And in part A, we're looking for the minimum possible period of rotation. In other words, how fast can this thing revolve before the string breaks? So basically, what we're looking for is, what's the period that corresponds to a tension of 25.5 newtons? We look at a quick force analysis. So the force exerted by the string is inward toward the center of curvature, and that's what's supplying our centripetal force here. I'm going to call that Ft. And we apply Newton's second law to this mass. And the only force it experiences is that tension force pointing to the center of curvature. So that's Ft. And then the mass is little m. And then the acceleration here is the centripetal acceleration of the mass. Now, we could write that as v squared over r, but then we'd have some more work to do to get that in terms of the period. It's better to just remember the formula for centripetal acceleration in terms of period, and that's 4 pi squared r over t squared. So ultimately, what we're going to do is plug in a tension of 25.5 newtons, and then just figure out what period corresponds to that. And that will be our smallest period, in other words, our fastest rotation rate, right before the string breaks. So we go about solving for t, and I'm going to go ahead and multiply both sides by t squared and divide both sides by ft. And then we square root both sides to solve for t. And the square root of 4 pi squared is 2 pi, so we'll pull that out. So there's our general solution. We have 2 pi square root mr over ft. Now all we have to do is plug things in. Our mass was 85 grams, which we need to change to kilograms, so that's 0.085. The radius of curvature, in other words, the length of the string, that was 1.22. meters, and we're going fast enough that the tension is at the maximum value of 25.5 newtons. So we plug that in for Ft. And when I run the numbers on this to 3 significant digits, I get 0.401 seconds. In part B, we're asked to find the maximum angular velocity corresponding to that period. And there's a couple ways of going about this. By far, the simplest way would be to just remember the relationship between angular velocity and period. So the angular velocity, that's in radians per second, is 2 pi over the period. And to 3 sig figs, this comes out to 15.7 radians per second. And that's a fine solution, but I also wanted to illustrate a more fundamental approach. If you didn't remember this conversion between angular velocity and period, well, we could just go back and do the problem from scratch, but apply the formula for centripetal acceleration in terms of angular velocity. And that's just r omega squared. When we divide by mr and then square root the result, we get the square root of Ft over mr. We plug in the numbers, and we arrive at the same 15.7 radians per second. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.